This video here, I'm going to show you how to pull and clean a flame sensor on a Carrier Bryant Payne day and night furnace. Furnace right here. I'm going to be descriptive as possible. This is the number one repair that I've seen in the industry in my 20 years of experience. Steady heartbeat. Now, on the front of the furnace, you're going to have all kinds of error codes, which will lead you into what could potentially be wrong with your furnace. A Carrier Payne Bryant furnace, 80%. This is where the flame sensor is. You can always tell the flame sensor because it only has one wire connected to it. Now, what's below that is the igniter. That's got two wires connected to it. The flame sensor only has one. So I'm going to take that out. If you're nervous about working on your furnace, the first thing you can do before you even open it up, turn your power off. Turn the gas off. The quarter inch screw, and I'm using my little impact just because it's long enough to reach in there. You could use a socket. Quarter inch screw. And now I'm going to pull that out. It should just pull right out. And that's pretty dirty, so I'm going to go ahead and clean it. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to the channel. If this works for you, I'd appreciate you hitting the thanks button, maybe donate to the channel. I'd really appreciate it. Piece of Scotch-Brite. You can use dollar bills. I always use Scotch-Brite. When you put it in, be careful not to over tighten it. You don't want to break this ceramic. In this particular furnace, I'm going to put the wire back on it. Remember, only one wire. And then we're going to put it back in the furnace. Sometimes that can get loose right here. You might want to pinch that up a little bit with some pliers before you put it on because you want a good snug connection. You really can't make a mistake when you put it back in because there's only one hole for a screw here. And if you look inside there, there's only one hole for a screw there. So let's put it back in. Always start that by hand. It has to be tight. Because if that screw ain't tight, you're not going to get a good ground and your furnace isn't going to work. Just going to tighten it up a little bit. Not a lot. It's tight enough. Next step is I'm going to turn the electric back on. As long as you turn your gas off when you're making any repairs, you're going to be pretty safe. Turn the electric off as well. And the way a carrier cycles is the blower motor always comes on first before it goes into heating. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Consider subscribing to the channel. If this works for you, I'd appreciate you hitting the thanks button, maybe donating to the channel. I'd really appreciate it. Anytime you can fix your own furnace and not invite a home service professional into your home, one, you're going to save money, and two, a lot of these technicians are incentivized to try and sell you new equipment. And I'm not saying all technicians, but I've ran across a lot of them in my time, and their main objective is to sell you something so they can make a bigger paycheck. And unfortunately, that's just kind of how it is in 2022. So, furnace lit. I'm gonna go ahead and leave a link in the description for a new flame sensor and a new igniter. If you're interested in finding out how to change an igniter on a Carrier Bryant furnace, leave me a comment down below. See you on the next one.